You having them? You with them? You against them? Producer Joe was with us a second or two ago. In fact, he's rejoined us here in studio.
He's here to face the music.
Because Joe was not happy at all last night. Not that Colchester eliminated Tottenham, that's one thing, but it's totally another thing that supporters decide to come on the pitch and celebrate. And Joe, just so that we're no doubt about this at all, you simply are not having it. You would want the offenders, even the Colchester fans last night who invaded the pitch, ban them for life?
Well, I reckon the majority of those people that came on probably don't go week in, week out. I often find it when you're a lower league club and you get a big team in the cup or you have a big team in the league come down. People that don't go every week come and ruin it for your club. I've had it at Millwall. I've been a Millwall fan since I was 9 years old. I've had season ticket for many years. I haven't been down for a while for other reasons, but they're still my team and I still love them and support them, but there's always that little minority that ruin it. You don't need to go on the pitch. There's no reason for it. I have the restraint to stay in my seat and enjoy it. And you're taking away from the players' achievement when you're doing that. Let them be on the pitch and celebrate. You can celebrate with them. Let them come to you.
Natalie,
don't go to them.
This is why, just before we take the calls, Trevor, this is why producer Joe is 100% right.
What?
Now, anyone listening in Scotland will remember this. I was there two or three seasons ago, Hibs Rangers Scottish Cup final. Hibs won it in the last minute. I think Gray got the winner. So Hibs fans come on the pitch at Hampden. And then what happened? Rangers fans came on the pitch at Hampden. Mm. And all hell broke loose. Before we know what we're looking at, we're all standing in the main stand watching out as mounted police are on the pitch, Trevor, trying to chase them off. Fist fights breaking out all over the place. It was carnage.
Yeah.
And that is why you cannot make one law for one club and another law
well,
for
there
another.
Isn't. There isn't.
And that's why producer Joe is 100% right.
You're
that
wrong,
Colchester
though,
fans
wrong.
Should not be on that pitch
it's
last night.
It's not one law for one club and one law for another. Colchester probably will get a fine for the pitch invasion, so they will suffer a consequence of it. But you are... that particular match obviously was vile what happened, and as you say, police on horseback had to come in, and
it's horrendous.
Yeah, but that didn't happen at Colchester last night. It was actually a very
but how
way,
can you have one law for one and not
but
another?
It's not a law, it's not, because
it's illegal
will be
to
fined,
go on the pitch,
but they will be fined, so they will still receive a punishment for it.
But it doesn't make it so it's wrong to do it.
I know, I said
it's
that already
wrong to do it.
I have said
it's wrong
I don't
to
agree
do
that people do it, but I don't have a problem if they go and do it, because it's that pure emotion of celebrating something they may never ever get to celebrate ever again.
That was the first time that Hibs had won the cup. That's why they went on the pitch.
If Scotland won the World Cup and fans ran on the pitch, you'd call them morons. You've never won the World Cup.
Shouldn't be on the pitch.
But you wouldn't be calling them morons at the time, because you'd probably celebrating
the moment.
Exactly.
Why would it ruin the moment?
Why do those fans think that it's all about them? They take it away from the achievement
because
of the players.
Because they're the fans that have been supporting
but
Scotland
and they have their own seats in the stadium, and that is where they should stay and support.
And what I would say is that is a sore point for Scotland fans, because the clowns all those years ago when Scotland beat England at Wembley, who went on the pitch, were swinging from the crossbar and brought the brinking crossbar down. They just disgraced
and because of
the
that,
name of Scotland.
And because of that, that's why we don't really have home nation matches anymore.
And
it?
That's why, I tell you what, if anyone is listening this morning who was at that cup final I've just mentioned, Hibs Rangers, and you were on the pitch that day, come on and tell us what that was like. Because it was utter carnage, it kicked off, and it went mad. If you're a Hibs fan who now regrets going on the pitch because you know they got involved in a fist fight with some Rangers fans, tell me what you remember of it. Do you regret it? Was it wise?
Of course there are moments that are, as you've just pointed out, regrettable and shouldn't have happened. So the Scottish Cup final that you've just referred to, the Scotland game, obviously there are moments when a pitch invasion, and I do it in inverted commas, turns nasty. And of course we don't ever want to see that. But they are so few and far between.
But that's why they can't happen at any time.
But they're not supposed to happen, but they do.
But these morons that run on the pitch, they're the same mentality of this bloke last night that's punched a horse at Portsmouth versus Southampton.
Oh, well, I mean, he is a moron.
These sort of people, that's the sort of person that runs on the pitch.
And Liam in Nottingham is saying this morning,
well,
just before we take a call, Jim, check the replay from the pitch invasion at Colchester last night. A Colchester fan gives Gazzaniga a slap around the head as he runs by him. Liam in Nottinghamshire is trying to tell us that. However, Joe, you and I are copying it, and Kieran's at us. Mm. Producer Joe sits at the back of the ground with his flask of tea in an away day. Him and Jim are trying to take the fun and passion out of the beautiful game, as per usual. Natalie, 100% right, the human versions of VAR.
But why can't you see the good in the sense that, that nothing bad happened as a result of those fans running on?
The goalkeeper getting a slap round the head, which, that's all right, is it?
Well, I didn't see that.
Let's hear from Chris, who's an Ipswich fan.
How many pitch invasions have there been over the course of history? There's been thousands and thousands and thousands of pitch invasions.
Absolutely.
It's only the odds, it's the odd few where you get some prat who comes on the pitch, like somebody punched Chris Kirkwood in the face, Hurst who punched Jack Grealish in the back of the head. You get prats who do that, but 99 times out of 100, nothing ever happens. It's just fans enjoying the moment, especially the smaller clubs where they don't get to feel that passion like a Man United fan or a Man City fan, where it happens, where success is like ingrained in the club. Small clubs don't get that, and the passion is just for that moment, like Natalie said earlier on, it might never happen again for Colchester.
Well, this is,
they're enjoying the moment.
And that's the thing, Chris, you know, obviously what happened with Jack Grealish, for example, that was in the game, that was happening in the game.
Yeah, an individual.
Yeah, it was one individual who ran onto the pitch, and obviously we all know what happened. Obviously that should never happen because there's a game going on. Now this invasion, I keep saying inverted commas, I don't want to call it an invasion.
Well, it is an invasion, so that's what you can call it.
I don't want to call it that though, because that is, how I see it is fans celebrating a momentous occasion for that team. Mm. This has happened after the match. The game is finished. Mm-hmm. So to me, there are two separate things, I have to say.
You've seen tennis fans do it in centre court at Wimbledon. Federer won, everybody on.
Do you know what? That argument is rubbish though, because there are other sports where pitch invasions happen. It used to happen in the cricket. It used to happen in the cricket all the time in the 80s of the Ashes, for example. You do get it in other sports. It cannot always just be down to it just happens in football. It doesn't just happen in football. It happens in other sports.
I actually enjoyed it with Blackpool Football Club when we earned a win to get into the promotion playoff places in the last game of the season. And it's friends and people that you know that are running on the pitch saying, oh my God, well done. It's a celebration.
You're coming away with the line, Trevor. You're all young, for pitch invasion.
I was only 18 years old. So yeah, my friends were young fans. They were friends of mine and they came on the pitch and gave me a big hug.
I remember being at a Brentford game and a former Brentford player was in the stands and he ran on the pitch.
Moral.
But he got caught up in it. He obviously loved the occasion of that particular game.
Johnny, the Derby fan, save us from ourselves. What are you saying? Good morning.
Great debate as well.
Good,
but I think Natalie, you've lost the plot. two years ago, I was at Derby, Fulham, away in the playoffs. So it was the second leg of the playoffs, and Fulham won, deserved to win, far better side. Soon as the final whistle went, the Fulham fans all run on the pitch to celebrate. Well done. What I consider a fairly small club have got into the playoffs. They start the Derby fans, because it's the last game of the season. So the Derby players are walking over to Derby fans to applaud them. The Fulham fans are running all over the pitch. After they've run all over the pitch, they come towards the Derby fans to start goading the Derby fans. There are confrontations between Fulham fans and Derby players. Then you've got Derby fans trying to get onto the pitch to confront the Fulham fans. There are kids getting squashed in the crush. Natalie, I don't know where you're coming from, but you've got it completely wrong.
Well, Johnny, do you know what? I understand exactly what you're saying, and obviously that shouldn't be happening. But again, that's once in a blue moon. It doesn't happen all the time. Last night, Colchester fans didn't go to Tottenham fans and goad them.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I totally agree, that should not be happening on a football pitch.
At any time.
Of course not at any time, in the sense of goading another set of supporters, but going on to celebrate what could have been a great win for Fulham in that instance, mm-hmm. I don't have a problem with it. They should have had security in place.
You're backtracking now, Nathan.
Not at all.
What's the French for cul-de-sac? You're in one.
How am I in a cul-de-sac? All I was going to say is they should have had stewards lined up, where I've seen it in many grounds, to prevent Fulham fans getting anywhere near those Derby supporters.
Producer Joe, the thumbs up, my man. I'm with you. Stay with us.
Rubbish.
We're talking about pitch invasions, or at least Producer Joe came through and was talking about pitch invasions last night. Some of the Colchester fans. I'm not sure how many, Joe, were there many of them? Go on the pitch at the end of the penalty shootout.
Hundreds.
Colchester eliminated Tottenham, and producer Joe said to us this morning, and to a large degree I'm with him, pitch invasions, sorry, no go. Shouldn't happen, because you never know what it could lead to. That's why we don't want to see them in football. But you can't just allow Colchester fans, who were, of course, celebrating. Good humoured, Trevor, we're all agreed about that. They want to celebrate, but at the end of the day, you never know what might happen.
Yeah, you never know what might happen, but good intentions, going on the pitch, celebrating, you know, patting one of your star players on the back. Well done, brilliant, beating Spurs. Beautiful.
Yeah.
It wasn't if it is just that, that's fine for me.
It happened at Crawley as well. Sorry, we don't want to just focus on Colchester.
Yeah, not singling out.
It happened at Crawley too. Yeah. So it's not just
harmless fun. And the club will get fined.
But great. So you're hurting your club. Oh, it's harmless fun, but the club will get fined. Well, I don't want my club getting fined. That's what I don't want. Fans need to realise they're harming the club. Can you not see that?
I understand that, yes. But it's too tempting to go on the pitch and celebrate.
Why is it? What's tempting about it? What are you going to get from it? I don't understand.
You might shake the hand of your star player. You might.
No, do you know what they're thinking? Majority of players on the pitch thinking, get off the pitch. Just get off. Now we had.
Were you thinking that?
I wasn't thinking that. Well, I was celebrating with mates.
Steve Morrison was in on Monday, Millwall legend. When he scored the winning goal at Wembley in 2017, the interview after the game, the first thing he said was, the interviewer said to him, Steve, how are you feeling? And he went, they've ruined it for me. They've ruined it for me. The fans running on the pitch, and they ruined it for me as well, because there's no need to run on the pitch and make it all about yourself.
Is he still a legend?
He's still a legend, yeah, absolutely. Steve's been a brilliant player for Millwall. But
I remember the interview,
Steve. Great for Steve for coming out.
I remember him saying
the majority of good fans are thinking, why are you going on the pitch? Just enjoy it in the stand.
And we're not going over the top about this, Natalie. But basically, the bottom line is it shouldn't happen because of what it might lead to. And we're well
what
aware
of
the Colchester fans.
To? What
I mean,
is it going to lead to?
It's illegal, right? You shouldn't be on the pitch.
I understand that.
And Trevor's just said, you're going to get fined. So you're harming your club by doing it. A true fan would not harm their club.
Well, saying that, I mean, this was a similar thing, but it happened during the game, and I was at the Blackpool game when the Owen Oyston family were in charge of the club, and they were fuming with the club and the way the club was being run, and they went onto the pitch during the game, and the game was cancelled. Now, when it's something like that, I mean, you know, obviously they've got the reasons for going on the pitch and they wanted to make a point. But for me, that's when it starts getting dangerous.
So if you're on to celebrate, it's okay. That's your bottom
line. I think if you're going on with harmless fun to celebrate and maybe pat one of your heroes on the back, I don't see the problem. Tell me what you gonna do, what you gonna do. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Bad boys, bad boys. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you?